scripture. As a matter of fact, several of their kings are all closed down the church. And then said, as a matter of fact, he has closed down the church and decided to worship somewhere else. But you gotta understand the context. When Hosea was prophesying, he was prophesying to a weak church. He was prophesying to a church that needed to be strong. He was prophesying to a kingdom that had strayed away from God. Now understand this. Israel was not the biggest country. Israel was not the richest country. Israel was not the most powerful country. Israel was a small little country. But God wanted the desires to be towards something that is small, something that can fend for itself. And so God said, these are my people. But when you stray away from the presence of God, when you stray away from the presence of the Savior, God only has one alternative. I'm not going to say to you, if you do this, then this will be the result. But in the midst of it all, although Israel strayed, God said to them, listen, you're not looking after other countries, other nations, but my love towards you is still great.
I don't understand God, what he does. But this one thing I know, that I know if I speak to myself, that I am wretched, that I am a sinner saved by grace, that if it wasn't for the blood of Jesus Christ, a pastor's car, if it wasn't for Christ just touching me and saying, Tim, I'm putting you out of the gutter, I'm putting you out of the sin. It's not because I'm related to so and so, or I come from that place, but it's because of the mercy and the unconditional love of God that he would look down into the world and say, sinners, and so, the prophet, the Bible says this, and the Bible speaks of the meaning of the prophet's name is salvation. The meaning of Gomer's name is completion. So what took place? God said, I would send salvation to a wretched sinner. And when Jesus, in the form of the prophet, in the name of salvation, reached down and touched Gomer, Gomer's life was never the same, simply because she never met a man like Judah. 1 minute, oh God, I've been with strength, and God keep coming back and said, listen, I want you to show up. I really love you. I want you to be, oh God, my people, and I want to be your God. But if you don't want anything to do with God, but it wasn't until, hey God, if the thing starts to dry up, with God, and God, and the lovers didn't love her anymore, and they didn't give her stuff anymore, and because the stuff started to dry up, oh God, she found herself back to her lover, back to the one that loved her. Let me tell you something, we can go around town, checking out everybody else, but there's gonna come a time that we can have to stop and say, God, I know what you love me, and he said, return back to me. The prophet went to a couple of nightclubs looking for Goma. Could you imagine? The pastor on Blue Road going down to Luna looking for the pastor's wife. You know, let me tell you something. I know the tabloid of the Church of God prophecy would have it all through. Listen, I'm telling you, but there's some things that we have to do in this dispensation, because the God we serve is the God who is able to reach down and say, I will go wherever it takes for me to get and get my lover, to get the one that needs me. We've got to stop giving up on our children.
Understand this, folk, that there's some of us, and that the Bible says,
what he says. Sow to yourselves in righteousness. And so he's saying to us, Sister Alba, instead of sitting down watching scandal and all about your foolishness, sow to yourselves in righteousness. You're wondering why we can't do righteous simply because we are not sowing righteousness. So God is saying, before you even cut the crown, think about me. Think about righteousness. Because what's going to go after that is the mercies of God, the love of God. Then he says in the word of God, I'll break up the fallow ground. I'm going to just take a couple of minutes of building. Now, I know I'm a kind of silly children, and it seems laughable, but when you're in sin, folk laugh at you. Oh God. When you're in sin, people laugh behind your back, oh God, because you do silly stuff. Oh God, let me tell you something. God is saying, break up the fallow ground. Out of local shall I. In order for you to break up the fallow ground, it must have meant that there was some other farming going on before. And because you allowed the cares of this world to get into your life, God is saying, you gotta break it up again. Go back again. Oh God, do the work. Thank you. And what we got to do, sister, go on. Take off some layers. And draw on the other side. All right. We still got some stuff. And some of us still walking around with some stuff. And it might be the preacher, even the praise and worship leader. I got me still walking around with some stuff. But God is saying, God to Israel and to this church, break up the fallow ground. Righteousness, reap in mercy, break up your fallow ground, oh God. It didn't tell you that the prophet break up the fallow ground. It didn't say, I'll let the television and the televangelist break up, oh God, the apostle. It says, break up your fallow ground. Simply, talk to the team, oh God, get rid of the stuff, get rid, oh God, of the weight and the sin that does so. Sinners, but somehow we still holding on. I got some sheets. I got some layers of sin. You see one thing about sin? Sin is a way of layering up. I got, I know we talk about press down, shake it together, and that's the word. But when we compound our sin, it presses us down. I got, it accumulates to the point that it's weight.
Set aside and refuse to go.
We don't need no more government. All we need are some sanctified believers.
This is why I believe that we're on a good timetable. Because this message or this thing, Bishop, comes at an appropriate time. Because Uzziah prophesied in the time of Hezekiah. He prophesied in the time of Ahaz. He prophesied in the times of Uzziah, Hakok. And so he's prophesying. His word comes to us. And it says, people of God, don't come to church to look good. Don't dress up in your best. And then you left your best home. In the name of the Father, God is saying, Bishop, I know I'm the best that you have. Hallelujah. I'm not getting any younger, but I believe that if, as I get older, I will give God my best. I will give him all that I have. I will give him to pay me out.
And some of us,
And this is where the church has to shift to. Breaking up the fallow ground is not for the easy. We're watching too much television. And we want our ministries to look like television ministries. We want everything to line up in place. And that power may come up and everybody's smiling. No, that ain't ministry, COGOP. Ministry is when you finish preaching, COGOP. And somebody come in and say, Pastor, I'm 9 months pregnant and my mommy just put me out. What you gonna do? Are you gonna close?